We're going forward in our series of shiurim on the Sefer Das Elokim as our Hakdama to Chochmas Emes. We're holding on Daf Chav Tes in the middle of his section on the Oris HaChoitim. We explained yesterday that before the system of Atzilus, where Kaviyachol our Gilia Lekus is, our Gilia of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the place where we are Typhus, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Kaviyachol, there are Shroshim for that Gili. And the Shroshim for those Gili is the system we know of as the Oizim Choytim Peh, which is the first Gili that the Rav wants to speak about coming out of Ak. Even though, and at what point we use these Kinoi. But the Etzim, really, they're talking about the same thing. So in other words, sometimes we can work backwards. What we can do is this, even though the Rav might not speak about the Ab to Ak, let's say, because he'll say that it's too high. But the Maisa, he will speak about the Arach, and there's a lot of Torah in the Rav on Arach. So Menasa, working backward from Arach, you can apply that to Ak. In fact, the Rav, in Shir Sakelim, beginning of Perek Vav, explains that Kol Ma'ashi Yesh Ba'arach, there is an Ak. So Menasa, in Arach, we're going to see, Bezos Hashem Yisbarach, there's a B'china of Agolgalta, and there's a B'china of Neiman, there's a B'china of Sa'aris, there's a B'china of what's called Chavrati. And these are all Tetzos of the Ab of Arach. So Mamela Ak will also have this. It's just the Rav doesn't want to speak about this when he talks in terms of Ak. He wants to start from the Sag. Because like we said before, because the Sag is the beginning of, from the Sag, that'll be the beginning of the Gili of the Ma and the Ben. Because remember, Sag is Bechinas Ema, and that's the Em HaBanim, the Banim being the Ma and the Ben. The Ma and the Ben of Ak is what makes up Atzilus, because that's Mislavish Min Tabar Lamata. And the Tabar Lamata is where Atzilus is going to be, because that's the next item after Ak. Because the entire Achab system, which are Toitzos of Sag, and Punkt Da'ab of Sag, as we know, they are all considered are lomas of Ak, because they're lomalim in a parsa. The parsa being by the Mokum Tabor, we're going to get this lashon later when we get into the olam of Nekudos and the olam of Atzilus, because there's a separation that's made between one olam and the next olam. And Bez Hashem Yisbarach, when we get there, we'll go into what exactly the separation is, how it's made, what it means, why it's muchach that there is this separation. But so of course, if you don't have that in Achab with Ak, or at least not Kipashis, you don't have that. And the Achab system are basically the Shroshim, again, for the Atzilus system, so therefore it's Negeos to know that. Now, Punkt, we're going to see that it's really only the Oyer Sapeh of the Achab system, which are the Etzim Shroshim for Atzilus. So therefore, the Rav is going to speak a lot about the Oyer Sapeh, and he's going to describe that system in detail. But Torah is Shoresh for what the Atzilus system that comes after it. But as a Shoresh for the Oyer Sapeh itself are the Oyer of the Asnaim and the Oyer of the Choytim. Because remember, because the Oyer of the Oizen and the Choytim and the Peh act as Sag Mahaben, or a Bina, Zerampim, and a Malchus. And we're going to go more into this, God willing, in detail when we speak more about this, just to put it in place. Because one of the Iker things in Chachmas Emes is knowing exactly where you're holding. So right now we're holding in the Taimim Em Soin, because remember, Taimim correspond to Ab. And we're dealing in the Taimim of the Sag, or the Ab of the Sag. And the Taimim Em Soin of the Ois would be the Chinus of the Choytim. And we say that corresponds to Zerampim. And Melech, since we know that there's a Nek of Yamin and a Nek of Samoil, the Nek of Yamin is going to be the Chinas Yisrael, the Nek of Samoil is the Chinas Yankov, because Shefa Mitzad Gavlus and Shefa Mitzad Katnus, or Mashbiya Mitzad Gavlus and Mashbiya Mitzad Katnus. So at this point, we don't have Kalim yet, because we don't have this Betisha, or this unification of the Oris Makif in the Pinim, because we still have two orifices, Kaviyachol, by which the Oris is coming out, just like we had up in the Oris of the Asnaim. But we do have more of a Gili because they're closer together, Kaviyachol. And as we see in Bachzer Zalakol, we see that the ears are farther apart on a person's head than his nostrils are. So that's going to be the major chilik between the Oris of the Choytim and the Oris of the Asnaim. So this is where we're up to now. Again, page Chav Tes in the Sefer, and we're up to V'nachsu L'Oyer Sachoytim, which is the third paragraph. So let's go. V'nachsu L'Oyer Sachoytim. Let's go back to the Oyer Sachoytim. Hinei kan b'choytim nizkar v'yoyser Oyer Sapinimi m'makifim. So again, you have more of a hiskarvus, the pinimis and the makifim. Ki nikvi achoytim heim yoyser krovim zeh l'zeh minikvi azlaim. Because push it, because the nostrils are closer than the ears are. But since they're not in his karvelagami, like in the peh, because in the peh there's only one orifice by which the pinyan makif will come out of. So therefore, you still don't have kelim; you only have oyers. Because like we explained before, it was this inyan of the betisha, which is the same thing as a zivik, which we really haven't described yet what a zivik betzim means. But be'etzim, there's no way of the oyers of the makifim being shoyev the or hagas. From the Or Hazach, rather, from the Or Hagas, in order to build the Kalim. And since there's no way to make that Or Hazach separate itself from the Or Hagas, so Mele Kinim cannot come into being in the Oris of the Choytim. But there will be more of a Gili. And that's what he's going to say now. But what do you have in Arz Chaitim more than you had in Asnaim? So we represent this as Tam and Ois Hei Achas. Because remember, because there were, it was Mechuber, the Dalet, the Vachinus Dalet and the Vav, which makes up the Hay, and that was Moira on the Hay part Sufim, which is another way of understanding and representing the Esser Spheres. Because when we're representing them, remember, in terms of Pratim, we call them spheres, and in terms of Kolim, we represent them as Partsufim, because and they represent the five steps in every endeavor, Sairuch Mistek endeavor, or Rahavil Lagash Mistek endeavor, as we explained. So at the point of Choytim, we're still dealing with a tremendous unity. In the point of the Asnaim, we're still dealing with more unity. However, Vakan Bechaitim, right, is part of the Nasr Shtei Oisis Dalet and Vav. But here, this Hay is going to split up. So there will be more of a Gili. Now, it's not an Etzem Gili yet, of course, because we don't have a Kli yet, quote unquote. But Saif Kosaif, there will be more of a Gili. Ki Ois Vav, Shahaisen Elemis Toich Ois Hay Hanal, because that Vav, which was in the Hay, Bar Ois, and Hine Niglis Atab Chaitim. Now it'll be Nigla, Vyotil Chutz, the Nasr Ois Bisne Atzman, it becomes its own Ois. Vine Vav, Zu, Shiz Galfikan, he Soid Zer Ampim. Like we explained before, because the Vav of the Shem Havayah corresponds to Zer Ampim, because that's the poil. That Vav is, in other words, if you look at it like this, look at a Yud Kei Vav Kei system. You look at just the Ois Yud itself. Ois Yud is really a Nekuda Katana, but it has within the Gimel Kutzen. It's because it has within the Shrushim of the Rosh Toch Seif, which is what makes up the system. Where you're coming from, where you are, and where you're going, which is what Shefa is all about, and how Shefa transfers, and how the Shefa goes down, because it has to start somewhere, Kaviyoho. It has to be somewhere, it has to go somewhere. In the same way with us. We are somewhere, we are going somewhere, and we have a destination. Except when we look in terms of the Shefa coming down, we call that Mayim Dechurim, which is the Shefa coming down, and in Mitzad us, we call it Mayim Nukvin, which is our His Iris to latch onto that Shefa. So that's us down here going up. So the Iris of the Choytim are going to be the Shroshim for the Inyan of Zer Ampim, which is Merumis in the Ois Vav, because just like you have two Hays, the Hays are always being the Makablim, because you have a Makabal Elyon, which is Bechinas Bina, and then you have a Makabal Tachton, which is the Hay Achronim, which is Bechinas Malchus. Sometimes he calls the Hay Rishon, he calls it Bechinas Yovel, and he calls the Hay Achronim Bechinas Shmita, because one is at a higher level, one's at a lower level. Because one's a Bechinas Makabal in the Meichen, because remember the Bina is the Makabal of the Chachma. Again, the plan, you know, the plan is the makabel of the idea, and the heach reina, which is the house built, is the makabel of all the pa'ulas that had to build the house. So the vav is really just an expansion of that yud, but it's more of a mogushim dika version of that yud, if you will, because it's the yud stretched out in essence. So anyways, so the vav represents the pekina of zer ampim, or the pekina of the pa'ula. So sheniglas v'yotzim mei ima l'chutz. That's yotzim mei ima l'chutz. What he means by that is that kaviochel again, with our mashal tzuris adam, like a person is noilet from his mother. Now bina represents or ima, as we know, and the ars of the asnayim were bechinas ima. So from the bechinas of the asnayim, they will be noilet another bechina called ars of the choytim, which is bechinas za, and that will be mashbiya to the next oilam, which will be bechinas ars apeh. And Bez Hashem Yisrach will get more into this, because you see, again, the Mechaber here, who's quoting the Rav, is expressing that there is a system inherent within the Achab, and it's a system mitzad itself. And when you look at it mitzad itself, it works like every other system works, because remember, lo'olam kol b'prat shavim. So if the Achab system is going to be the Shrashim for the Atzilus system, so we can work our way backwards, because we know, based on the Rav, of course, how the Atzilus system works. So Mela, backwards, we can look at the Achab system, which is the potential of the Atzilus system, and see how it works also. So just like there'll be a Halbasha of Zer Ampim on Bina, meaning that you can look at Zer Ampim as the Ben, and you can look at Bina as the mother. And just like every higher Oilam, or every higher parts of it, grafts onto the lower parts of it. We say the lower parts of it is Slavish on the Nahi of the Oilam. Because remember, the Nahi is the one that's Labar Megufay. Because remember, because the Chabad of every parts of it is really what's higher than the parts of itself. The Chagas is the Mokin where it's holding right now, and the Nahi is where it's going to. That's outside the system, so we call it Bar Megufay. So therefore, the connection between the Ben and the Aim will be Ayideh the Nahi. So we'll say that Zer Ampim is Mislavish itself on the Nahi of Ima. So this, as in Banim Kari Deavuha, literally Pshuta Kamashmoi Kari the Deavuha, the feet of the father, or Uber Yerech, Yerech being the thigh, the feet of the mother. So that's what's happening over here too, in essence, that the relationship between the Aznayim and the Choytim is literally the relationship between the Ben and the Aim. Because the Aznayim will the Iris of the Choytim rather will be mislavished themselves on the Iris of the Aznayim, just like Zer Ampim down in Atzilus is mislavished itself on Emo. Except up here in the Achab system, we're talking in terms of Shroshim. Down when we're going to be talking in Atzilus, we'll be talking in terms of Pu'ula Mamish. Okay. So again, so we're saying here, Shenegel v'yosef me'a ima l'chutz, kenoid v'tzir s'dal oisiz havaya, as we know from the tzir s'dal oisiz havaya, because that hey rishoyna has within it also a vav, that vav, the vav on the dalet. Now, when it's still be me'a imoi, kavyachol, because, you know, before it's noilet, that's that vav which is in the hey rishoyna. Once it's noilet, if you will, then it takes its own shape, and that's that vav inside itself. And that's what's happening over here. That, those are the oiris of the choytim. But you don't have just one ois, which is called vav. It's divided into six chalakim, which is gematria six v'nikudos, shekalulim ba'oisav, which is kalul in that vav. V'heim vav alafim, and that's vav alafim. The reason why you have vav alafim, the Rav explains, is because if you look at a nostril, let's say, you know, lahavdol, you would have, let's say, a nikudah, you know, I guess would be the nostril, and then you have another nostril, and then you have the, I guess, the piece of skin on the nose that's in between them. So if you think about it, you would have, like, let's say, just like an aleph is kind of like a b'china on top, like a yod on top, and a kind of like a yod on the bottom, and there's like a line separating them. You know, a dash going down the middle. That's how an aleph is made. So that's the chayr is similar to what the way a nose looks with its nostrils and the skin between it. Now the reason why it's split into vav alafim, you know, let's just finish this and then I'll explain. Uba iris, okay, hapeh, right? Nisgalis hadalit. Now, but the iris of the peh will be nigla, will be magula the dalit, because dalit is haklula ba'ois hey, but sirs arba alafim and it's surah of four alafim. Kumoshis bar shem yisafin shemaim, as we're going to explain there. Because we're going to see Be'ezus Hashem Yisbarach that this hey, Rishona, is noilid zer ampim and nukva, both of them. Because they're both, because you have to understand, zer ampim, remember, is the bechina of the poyo, whereas nukva is the bechina of the makabel. And we explained before that in terms of ruchnius, there's something called chasadim and gevurs. Chasadim are mispashit, because they want to be mispashit, they want to be mashpia. Gevurs, on the other hand, want to circumscribe, and they want to limit. And through the limitation of the hispashis, then a gili can occur. Because if there's constant hispashis, there is never a gili, because nothing ever stops. So that's what goes and that puts it together. In fact, whenever we talk about zivugim in Chachmas Emes, or Yehudim in terms of Chachmas Emes, that's what we're referring to. We're referring to a unification of the mashbil with the makabel. Because if you have pure mashbil alone, if you would have pure za alone, if you will, without any makabel, it would just keep on going forever and ever and ever. And that's really what Bechinas Ein Sof is all about, or because what it is it's, again, it's pure potentiality, but nothing, but no definition to it at all.
Or without keli.
Or without a kli, yes. Masha Inkin, if we were dealing with, let's say, just the dalit, and Nukva is almost merumas in a dalit, and blushing dal, because lace the garment klum, because she only has what she's being makabel, then what you would have is you would have pure blackness. You would have gevurs without a mituk, if you will, which you see constantly in the Sfarim. Mituk literally means a sweetening of the gevurs, which doesn't make much sense in English. But what it means is that it's pure gevura without the kli, so mela, I mean without the or. So it'd be pure and utter blackness. In fact, Ra, the antithesis of Toiv, stems from Gevurah without a mituk. Because what happens is because if you have Gevurah without a mituk, Kavi Ochel, it's as if you don't have the aura of a Kadosh Baruch Hu there. So it's Yitochen to say, Kavi Ochel, that Hashem is not there. And so that would be pure Hester. I mean, Chashashom to say such a thing, but that's what Ra is. Ra would be the matzav of Hester from a Kadosh Baruch Hu where the aura is not coming into. So therefore, we're going to see Be'ezus Hashem Yisbarach. Then the Oiris of the Nekudos, what happened was, which we're not up to yet, but we'll see, that was a stage where there was a Gevura without the proper Mituk, without the proper Zivik between the Or and the Kli. So you had a Kli, but you didn't have any Or yet. So therefore, we're going to see that Ra, evil, comes from the Olam HaNekudos. Masha Inkein, if you have a proper Mituk, therefore, you have the proper mizik of the chasadim and the kavuras, and from there you can have a bria. And that's what it means to zivuk. In fact, when we say like Hashem brachos mezavik zivugim, what does he do? Remember every Sheva brachos Torah, we say Hashem is mezavik zivugim. Well, what does that mean exactly? Well, that means is he's taking together these two primal koyches of bria, the koych of his pashtus and the koych of his talkus, or the koych of or and koych of kli kavyochol, and he's putting them together. And by putting them together, we're coming to a bria. So therefore, mamela within that, so zerampim will be the vehicle by which the chesodim express themselves, and nukva will be the vehicle by which the gevuras express themselves. So it will be the kelim for these koyches. Both of them are licht in the original hey rishona with the dalet and the vav. Now the reason why the Machaber here, when he's quoting the Rav, is saying that there are six olives, is because Zer Ampim is different than the other Partsufim in the terms of the fact that it's not Makbel one sphere, but it's Makbel six spheres. Chesek Vur Tiferes, Netzachoid and Yesoid. In fact, a lot of times it's called the Vak or the Vav Ketzavis. So the Vav Ketzavis a lot of times is synonymous with Za or Zer Ampim. So when you see Za and Vak, you should know that they are Kinuyim, and they really make reference to the same thing. Well, basically, the same thing at least. The reason why that is because Chesek Vur Tiferes Netzachot Yisoid are all different attributes of being Mashbiya. You understand, Chesed, Lamashal, is to say, come on, let's go ahead with the project. Because remember, we have the idea, the Ratzon is already there to go ahead. That was the Kesser. The idea is already there to go ahead, because that was the idea which the Ratzon was Noilid to build the house, let's say. The plans are already there. That's the Bina. Remember, we went to the architect, we got the plans. And remember, and the Bina had to shim with the Chachma. That's the Machina of Das, because both of them were put together, because the architect has to do what you want. You understand? Otherwise, because the Bina has to shim with the Chachma. So therefore, now we have Das. Das is the Machina of moving ahead. So now the plans can now go to the contractor, and you can go and you can start moving and start actualizing this.
Start building
the, in actuality. The Chesed says, come, let's go and build. And let's build and build and build. You know, because the plans don't give you the actual materials by which to build with. So maybe the plans will give you the plans for the kitchen, let's say, but they won't say are going to use for mica countertops or are we going to be using marble countertops. So the Chachma says, come, let's make ourselves a $100,000 kitchen. Come on, we can do it. The Bina, the Gevura, on the other hand, which is on the left side, an Anuf of Bina, circumscribes and says, well, you know, the truth is, I don't think we're going to be able to afford a $100,000 kitchen. I don't think it's going to work. I don't think we're going to be able to do it. We're going to have to, it's too much. And so the Tiferes, which is in the middle now, functions as like the Bechina of Das, because that functions as the happy medium between the Chesed and the Gevura. So that's in terms of the builder. Okay, but remember, the builder has to build the house for the person who's going to live in that house. You understand? So therefore, there's now another triad below the Chagas, because the next triad, the Netzach, Choyd, and Yesoid, are looking at the building of the house from the point of view of the one that's being built for. In other words, Chesed Gvur Tiferes is the builder himself building the house. But Netzach or Yesoid is the one that is being built for. So Netzach says, "Why you're going to love it. Come on, let's build as much as we can. Well, you know, let's be as much as we can." But Hoyd says, no, it's too much. You can't do it. You've got to hold back. Whereas Yesoid is now, again, the happy medium over there. So therefore, within Zer Ampim itself, you have a miniature Oilam. Because over there, you have a miniature Mashbi and a miniature Makabal there also. Even though Enachanami the Heach Reina, the Malchus or the Nuktazar will be your Emes and Makabal, and that will be your Makabal HaKloli. But within Zer Ampim itself, you have a miniature Mashbia and a miniature Makabal, because you have the contractor, but then you have you, the client. So therefore, the contractor, again, is the beginning of the Chagas. The contract, you yourself, the one who wants the house, will be the Chin of the Nai. And both of you guys have to shtim with each other too. So therefore, all of these Vav Bechinas, they're all marumas in Zer Ampim, and therefore they're all sub-bechinas of Zer Ampim, and they're not bechinas mitzvah themselves. Because the emes is really, if we wanted to, we could split up any of the parts of them into Ezer spheres. Because remember, parts of it is just Meyer on a whole, where spheres is Meyer on a prod. It's just in Zer Ampim, since we're dealing in the building stage, and since each of these stages are negated to the building, Mamela, we do split them up there. So therefore, Zer Ampim will be quit of these six spheres. So therefore, to show that Zer Ampim, at its source being the Ayers of the Choytim of Adam Kadmon, has within it these six Bechinas, therefore we're Merumis, this Vav, as six Aleph. And Aleph, remember, is Merumis to this, because it's in the Kuda El Yaina of the Aleph, because that's going to be the Mashbiyah, There's a Makuta Katana of the Aleph, that's the Makabal, and then there's a line in between them, right, to show how they're how the Mashbiya and the Makabal are connected with one another. So at this point already, we're going to have a shortage for that. And that's why the Rav says that over here. Mashikin, when we get into Oyer Sapeh, which will be the next one, that will be the Bechina of the Dalet, because that's going to be the Makabal HaKloli for that Vav. Okay, we'll stop here.